Hi friends, in this video we are going to learn about functions. Okay, so functions are the basic components of a modular programming. So what do we mean by modular programming? Modular programming means we will be dividing the whole program or task into subtasks, and we'll be solving each subtask first, and we'll combine the result of each subtask to get the whole solution. So that's the programming practice which we are used in modular programming. So using C programming, we'll be implementing functions to implement modular programming. Okay, so functions are program segments. That means we are dividing the whole program into different segments, and we will be implementing that using functions. And it can increase readability of a program, and it helps to use in different places. That means whenever we need to use same set of statements repeatedly in some places, we'll be using the help of loop. Any loop we can use to repeatedly executing some steps, right? If suppose we want to repeatedly use some steps in different places of the program, then we can use functions. That will be very useful in that places. So it helps to use in different places, and it can be used repetitively. How many times we can use? Any number of times in any places of the main program. So the functions will help to divide programs into different parts, and which makes program more simpler. So these are the advantages of using functions. Clear? Now how the functions works. So we are having a main program and a function which is implemented. Okay, so inside the main program there are sequence of steps we need to perform, and after that, in between the sequence of steps, there is a function call. Function call is the statement which uses to call that particular function. Clear? So whenever this function call occurs, that control will transfer to that function. That means it starts executing that function statements inside that function. So after completing all the execution of all the steps which are included in the inside the function, it will come to the next statement wherever the function called. Okay, so this is the working of the function, and it will execute the remaining statements inside the main program. So inside the main program there will be a statement called function call which calls the function, and whenever this call occurs, the control will transfer, the compiler will start executing the sequence of steps which are used inside this function. So after executing all the statements inside the function, it will come back to the next statement after the function call and will execute the remaining statements inside the main program. Clear? So this is the working of a function. So how can these two communicate? We can communicate between main program and functions by passing values. Okay, so here the communication takes place to passing values in between main program and functions. Whenever we are sending some values from main program to the function, these are known as arguments. So arguments are the values which are transferred from main program to the function, and whatever values passes from function to main program is known as return value. Clear? So return value is the values which are given from function to the main program, and arguments are the values which are given from the main program to function. And there are two types of arguments: formal arguments and actual arguments. Okay, so formal arguments and actual arguments are the two types of arguments, where actual arguments are the original values which are given from the main program. Okay, so actual arguments are the original values which are passed from the main program to the function, where formal arguments are the place to receive that actual arguments. So all the time formal arguments may be some temporary values or temporary storage areas. Okay, so whenever some values are passed from the main function to the function, then we need some place to hold that value. So that are known as formal arguments. Clear? Actual arguments are the original values which are given from the main program to the function, and formal arguments are the places to receive that particular actual original values. Clear? So we can compare it with a giving and taking type of communication. That means, if suppose we have a vehicle, so you are having a vehicle and you need to share your vehicle with your friend. Okay, so what will we do? We will be giving the key to our friend, right? So we will be having a car key, and this car key is given to our friend. So this can be imagined as a main program, ourselves as a main program, and our friend is a function. So whenever he is asking for our help or our vehicle, we will be giving that key. Okay, so the key is the argument passing between the main program and function. That means we are giving the key, right? So here this key is the actual argument, and this key will be received by our friend. So this is a formal argument. That means this is the place to keep this key for temporary. Okay, so this is the actual argument. That means this key actually belongs to us, right? We are giving this to our friend for some time. Okay, so he is having the place to hold that for some time, temporarily. So these are the concepts between actual argument and formal argument. Then we can pass the value or pass the actual argument in two different ways. These are pass by value and pass by address. Pass by value is like receiving duplicate key by the friend. Okay, that means we are having two set of keys. First one is original key, and we are having a duplicate key, and whenever our friend asks for the key, we will be giving the duplicate key. So in that particular case, just assume that some error occurred in, or some damage occurs in this duplicate key. What happens? It won't affect our original key, right? So that's the advantage of pass by value. So whenever the main program calls for the function and we are passing the value, by giving a duplicate value, actually we are having some value. The main program will have the original value, and it will be copied and given to the function. Okay, so there will be a copy of the original values. So whatever changes which will be made in the duplicate or the formal argument will not affect the original argument or actual argument in the main program. That's the advantage by pass by value. Clear? So in pass by value, we can assume it as receiving duplicate key. That means we are having original values, and whenever we need to pass, the main program needs to pass values to the function, it will create a copy of the actual values, and this copy will be given to the function. So whatever changes which is made by the function in the formal arguments will not affect the actual argument. Okay, so this is pass by value. Second method is pass by reference. Here the scenario is like sharing same key. Okay, we are having only one key and this key will be given to our friend. So if any damage occurs this key, this will affect ourselves, right? So this is the case of pass by reference. So whenever main program wants to give some values to the function, it will be giving the same argument. Actual argument is received as such, as formal argument. That means whatever changes inside this function makes in the formal argument will affect the actual argument inside the main program. Clear? So these are the two methods used to pass the values or passing arguments. Pass by value and pass by reference. In pass by value, whatever changes made inside the formal argument will affect the actual argument. Okay, in the second case, pass by reference, that means the original values will be shared. Okay, so in that case, whatever changes made in the formal argument may reflect in the actual argument. Clear? So these are the two type of methods, two methods to pass arguments between two functions. Clear? Then how to implement a function? We need to give three parts of the function to implement. Okay, we need to give first function prototype or declaration, then function definition and function call. So after giving these three parts only, the function implementation will become successful. Okay, function prototype or declaration, function definition and function call. So what is function prototype? Function prototype is the declaration of function. So whatever functions we are using inside a program, we need to declare that in the very beginning. Clear? So whenever we are using any variables inside the program, we will be declaring each variable in the starting of the program, right? So likewise, whenever we are using a function, we need to declare that function in the beginning of the program. Okay, and the syntax for function declaration is return type, function name, arguments. Okay, return type is nothing that if after some processing, suppose function wants to return some value, then we need to specify what type of value is returned by that particular function. So this is the return type. Then we need to specify a name for the function. And these are the arguments where it specifies that what are the values are communicated between from main function to the function. Okay, with the semicolon. So inside function prototype, we need to give semicolon. Okay, so return type, function name, arguments. There may be cases in which there is no return value or no arguments. If there is no return value, this return type will be void, void. Void will be the return type for nothing to return. So if there is no arguments between the main program and a function, then there is no need to specify any arguments. Just you can use the brackets. Okay. So this is for function prototype. Then function definition means we need to specify what to do by the function. So this defines what to do. Okay. And syntax for this is the first one line, which is just similar as the function declaration. That is the return type, function name and arguments. If suppose there is no return value, then we need to specify it as void. And if there is no arguments, we can just give brackets. Okay. Then insert curly braces. We need to specify the statements to execute inside the function. what are the steps to implement or what are the steps to perform by the function, we need to specify inside this curly braces. So this is function definition. After that, after defining a function, we need to call the function, right? So it is known as function call, the statement used to call that function. Syntax for this function call is different for without return value and with return value functions. If there is no return values, then we can directly call with the name, function name. If there is any arguments, we can specify the arguments also with semicolon. Clear? If suppose there is any return value, we need to specify a variable where to receive that particular value from the function. Okay, so return type variable equal to function name of arguments. That means this function will be called here and this function will return a value and this value will be stored inside this variable. Okay, so the function call will be different for without return value and with return value. If there is no return value, we can directly call it by using the function name. If there is any return value, we need to use assignment operator. Left side of the assignment operator should be the variable which is of the same type of return value. Clear? So these are the basics of functions. This is just concepts only. So whenever we are trying to solve problems or the explanation of function implementation will be done in the coming videos. So then you will get more clear about these functions. So thank you for watching this. If you find this very useful, please share it to your friends. Okay. Okay then. Bye. Thank you.